It's no secret that the gender pay gap in the film industry is staggering. Top actresses earn 5 to 10 times less than their male counterparts. Akshay Kumar makes the most through films, not commercials or business ventures, while Deepika Padukone is the highest paid. Deepika charged Rs 12 crore for Padmavat, and Bollywood's most sought after actress did not hide the fact that she was paid more than her co-stars Ranveer Singh and Shahid Kapoor. Deepika's fat Padmavat paycheck was in return of 200 commitment dates, which is not the amount of time Deepika allots to normal projects. Deepika's market price is anywhere between Rs 8 and Rs 10 crore per film. Priyanka Chopra is charging Rs 6.5 crore for her big Bollywood comeback opposite Salman Khan in Bharat. Hindi cinema's golden girl Anushka Sharma has been part of Rs 300 crore hits like PK and Sultan. She charges Rs 6, Rs 7 crore. The queen of Bollywood, Kangana Ranaut, increased her price post the super success Tanuvet's Manu Returns, but she failed to recreate the same kind of magic at the box office, forcing her to slash her price to Rs 5 to 6 crore per film. With Razi's unprecedented 122 crore plus success, Alia Bhatt has cemented her place as one of cinema's most bankable actresses. Alia charges between Rs 4 crore and 5 crore for a single movie. Veer the Wedding Star, Kareena Kapoor and Sonam Kapoor also charge between Rs 5 crore and Rs 6 crore, while Katrina Kaif charges in the range of Rs 4 crore and 5 crore. As far as male actors are concerned, mid and low level stars are paid by producers. Top stars like Akshay Kumar, Salman Khan, SRK and Aamir Khan produce almost all of their projects themselves. So there is no fixed return per film for these stars. In most cases, top stars keep the intellectual property rights of the film. Once they own the IPR, they own the satellite rights and the remake rights of the film. Recently, race-free satellite rights were sold for a whopping of Rs 140 crore. The highest amount earned by an Indian film for satellite rights. Then there's a percentage of profit or the profit sharing formula. The actor doesn't charge his normal market price but opts for a share of the profit. So his remuneration depends on how well the film does at the box office. Salman reportedly returned distributors as much as Rs 35 crore after Tube Light failed to light up at the box office. Sabse Bada Khiladi, the Akshay Kumar had given his nod for Gulshan Kumar biopic, but sources suggest that the producers offered Akshay anywhere between 27 crore to 30 crore for the film. Given the super success of Jolly LLB 2, Rustam, Toilet Ek Prem Katha, Padman and almost every other Akshay film, the actor's market price increased to Rs 45 to 50 crore. Akshay also wanted to retain the IPR of the film. Superstars such as Akshay and Aamir enter into a profit-sharing deal with producers where they take 70 to 80% of the profit, while the producer gets around 20 to 30%. So who is India's highest paid superstar? Aamir is out of the race as the actor is very selective about his projects and returns to the big screen after 2 to 3 year gap. Akshay had never had Rs 200 crore or 300 crore hit. So what Akshay makes from 4 films, Salman does from 2. But Akshay is certainly ahead in the competition simply because he guarantees a profit and keeps most of it. Akshay signs relatively low budget films, profit is huge and he does 3 to 4 films a year.